talking about Homi Bhabha is not easy, because he's a man of many, many splendors. A great scientist, theoretical physicist, great artist, you see, great musician, and tremendous expert in management. All the qualities he had. So the typical idea, my friend, in Bengal, to be a scientist, a woolly-headed, smoking, bearded, and not very clean, is not the image that he had. He was what he was. And because of his very splendid personality, he was liked across the country, including at that time Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru. Pandit Jawaharlal Nehru liked Homi, and Homi used to call Jawaharlal Nehru Bhai. Now you see from that picture, there is hardly any touch of India. At the same time, the great patriots. In fact, the affection and regard of Homi Bhabha to his parents and love for his mother is quite remarkable. They are brought up in Bombay, and I can't imagine how in Bombay he is wearing overcoat. There, Homi Bhabha writing at the age of 19 from Cambridge, I should read it out for those of young people particularly. I'm burning with the desire to do physics. Now Paul Dirac is one of the greatest theoretical physicists of quantum era of the last century. He completed his PhD in 1935 under the guidance of Fowler. Bhabha returned to India in 1939. In a short period, he gathered a team of young scientists around him. The program was built. Interaction with physicists across the world is a must. He initiated the atomic energy program in India very, very early. Bhabha is well known in physical sciences for the discovery of Bhabha scattering, still used. And of course, he was the first to propose the existence of a heavier cousin of neutron. Cascade theory he discovered. You see, Homi Bhabha is not a man to be defeated. Just after independence, there was hardly an experimental facility. He had the vision to realize without experimental facility, physical sciences would not be survived. You see, Bhabha was trying to do something electron, positron, scatter, and bump into the idea of exchange effect. He proved indirectly the positron can be a particle. But here, 1954, almost 18 years after Bhabha's theoretical prediction, this class says exchange effect is important, and Bhabha's formula proves the point. The exchange effect in motor scattering was easy to interpret as electrons are indistinguishable from each other. However, in case of electron positron scattering, interpretation of exchange effects on the basis of Dirac's Cole theory was somewhat ambiguous. Now we know any particle antiparticle pair will contribute to the extra effect irrespective of the particle. In fact, Homi Bhabha realized if you don't have a particle laboratory of high energy, well, the cosmos has no energy in the laboratory. Here he says something interesting. I know quite clearly what I want out of life. Life and my emotions are the only things I'm conscious of. I love consciousness of mind, and I want as much of it as I can get. Sir John Cockcroft, who discovered neutron, human progress is always dependent on the achievements of a few individuals of outstanding ability and creativeness. Homi Bhabha is one of them. This is a very interesting picture. Hideki Ibawa, John Archibald Wheeler, Albert Einstein, and Homi Bhabha. Homi Bhabha was trying to attract attention of Einstein and made him laugh, a smile. Now the other guys are very impressed. I suspect they're extremely nervous. Einstein around. But what Einstein is carrying in his belly is as good a guess as you can. This is the Tata Institute of Fundamental Research. Look at this galaxy of people, just one of them. This is an interesting picture of the Copenhagen Niels Bohr Institute. I have a pleasure spending a lot of time there in Copenhagen in the 1970s. Hawaii in the last row, step one. Second from the right, there was summertime famous lunchroom of Copenhagen Niels Bohr Institute. Bhabha was a great painter, another quality. Patrick in his jackets, very disturbed face, and Niels Bohr contemplating. Homi Bhabha, self-portrait at the age of 17, Cambridge. Angels sponsored a homage to Mozart, Bhabha painting. It's a striking portrait of his lady. Thank you. Nature 1938, the Maison Blanche thing. It's a great discovery. The decay of Maison helped resolving the enormous absorption of the penetrating component in the atmosphere. Bhabha did not believe in micromanagement. This is a very convoluted statement. If somebody really understands it, will send me a note. No energy is as expensive as having inadequate. I start to understand the meaning. Or maybe Bhabha thought that to make it convoluted, it would be interesting. First dedicated proton decay experiment at KG, it's not very known. This experiment was operational in 1992, and proton did not decay, but all the gold did, unfortunately. Dr. Ramana, my mentor, director of his group, Atomic Energy Establishment, asked in a so-called Atomic Energy Commission meeting that if he has cyclotron, and the pendulum. Otherwise, we miss out on nuclear physics. So, the commission agreed, although Bhabha actually is a particle physicist. The pendulum, which is in Bombay, where I started my life in India, and if you have cyclotron in Calcutta. The greatest tribute to Homi Bhabha is that what he set out to build against all odds has not only survived long after his untimely death, but has thrived and has been thriving.
The prayers that couldn't be finished. I know, but I know I haven't lost everything. That flower which couldn't bloom but wilted on the ground. The river which lost her way in the desert bed. I know I haven't lost everything.